Hi, welcome back. In this video, we will understand how to apply frequent pattern growth algorithm to the given set of transactions to find the frequent item sets and the association rules. These are the set of transactions given to us. There were 5 transactions, and in each transaction, a few items were bought. For example, in the first transaction, EKMNOY, these are the items bought. These are the hypothetical values. Each letter indicates one item in this case. The same thing goes with remaining transactions. The minimum support given to us is 3. If an item set is having the frequency 3 or more, that is called as the frequent item set in this case. Now we need to calculate the frequency of each item. There are different items are present, like A, C, D, E and so on. For every item, we need to identify the frequency. For example, the item A is bought only one time, so we used to write 1 here. The item C is bought 2 times, you can see here 1 and 2, so we write 2 here. Similarly, if you see M is bought 1, 2 and 3, 3 times, so we write 3 here. So this is how we need to find out the frequency of every item here. Once you write the frequency of every item, we need to find the frequency pattern set, that is L, which is built using all the elements whose frequency is greater than or equal to minimum support. So in this case, the minimum support is 3. Hence, we need to identify all those items whose frequency is 3 or more. For example, E is having frequency 4, so it will be considered as an element of a frequent pattern set. Next one is K, M, O and Y. Once you find these particular frequent item sets, they have to be arranged in the decreasing order. So first K will come, and then E will come. M, O and Y were having the same frequency, but M was bought first, and then O, and then Y here. So that is the reason, this is the order in which we need to keep it over here. Now once you find this particular frequent pattern set, that is L, next what we need to do is to identify the ordered item sets. So this is the frequent item set, frequent pattern set we found in the previous step. Using this, we try to find out the ordered item set. So these are the items, these are the ordered item set. So how to find out is, first we need to check which all items were present in the frequent pattern set, and we need to arrange them in the decreasing order. That's it. For example, E is present, K is present, M is present, O is present and Y is present. N is not present. So these items should be kept in the decreasing order. So K will come first because its frequency is 5, and then E, M, O, Y. This is the ordered item set. The same thing is repeated for the remaining transactions. For example, transaction number 4. In this case, C is not present in the frequent pattern set, and then U is not present. K, M, Y is present. So K is having frequency 5, so it will come first, and then M, and then Y over here. So once you identify the ordered item sets, the next step is to build the tri data structure, which is built something like this. We will start with the null node, and for every transaction's ordered item set, we will create a path here. For example, the first one is KEMOY. So for every node, or for every item, we will create one node, and initially we assign the frequency as 1 here. K is the first node, E is the second one, M is the third one, O is the next one, and then Y is the last one. So the frequency of every node is 1, 1 in this case. The second transaction is KEOY. So if you look at this particular thing, K, E is present, and from E there is no direct path for O here. So we need to add one more node here, that is O. And then we need to add one more node, that is Y. K and E were visited one more time, so the frequency will be incremented by 1, 1, and we will add O and Y as the two more nodes in this case. So the frequency of these two is 2, 2, and this is 1, 1 here. The next one is KEM. So K, E will be visited again, M is visited again, so it will become 3, 3, 2 in this case. So that is the next thing. KMY. So K, there is no direct path for M, so it will be 4. M will be added here, and then Y will be added here. So M will be 1 and Y will be 1 here. And then the last one is KEO. KEO, there is a direct path, so it will become 5, 4, and then this is 2 here. So this is the last the transaction inserted here. Once you do the this step, the next step is to identify the conditional pattern basis. So conditional pattern base for every node we need to identify, or every item we need to identify, that is Y, O, M, E, K. These are the items we have written in the ascending order here. For Y, what are the conditional pattern base? That is nothing but the path to reach that particular Y. So to reach this particular Y, there are three paths are there. K, E, M, O, that is the first one. K, E, O, that is the second one. K, M is the next one. And we need to write the frequency. What is this frequency? So what is the frequency of this particular Y? So in every case, one is present, so we write one here. So these are all the conditional pattern bases for Y here. Similarly for O, there are two paths to reach O, KEM and then KE. These are the two things. If I follow this party thing, the frequency is 1. If I follow this path, the frequency is 2. For the next one, that is M, we have only one path. There are two paths again. That's the one and this is the second one. KE, 2, K, 1 here. And if you want to reach E, there is only one path, that is K, and the value is 4. If you want to reach K, there is no node present before this, because there is a null in this case. So these are the conditional pattern bases. Once you find the conditional pattern bases, we need to find out the conditional pattern tree here, that is conditional frequent pattern tree. So how it is found identified is, we need to check the common element or elements from this conditional pattern basis. So in this case, K is the common over here. So K will come here and we need to add the frequency, that is 1, 1, 1, it will become 3 here. In the second case, KE is common, so KE will come here and the frequency will become 3 in this case. The third case, only K is common and the frequency is 2 plus 1, that is 3. In the next case, K is the only element, so K4 will be the thing. For the last one, K, there is no path in this case. We found conditional frequent pattern trees. Using this particular tree, we can write the frequent pattern rules. So how can we write the frequent patterns is, look at this particular thing. The item is Y and the conditional frequent pattern is K in this case. So the rule can be KY and its frequency, KY 3 here. Similarly, item is O and the conditional frequent pattern tree is KE. So KO is the one rule, EO is the second one, KEO is the third one. In every case, we need to write 3 as the frequency. The next one is KM, that is the only possibility and its frequency is 3. KE is the last possibility and its frequency is 4. Actually, we have to write 4 here. Now, this is how frequent patterns are generated. Once the frequent patterns are generated, the last step is to write the rules in this case. So, how to write the rules is consider one frequent pattern and then try to write the rules, all possible rules you can say. KY, what is the possible rule in this case? Only K tends to Y or Y tends to K. These are the two possible rules are there. For that thing, we need to calculate the confidence. So once you calculate the confidence of K tends to Y and Y tends to K, we need to check whether they are following or satisfying the minimum confidence. If K tends to Y satisfy, the meaning is K tends to Y is the association rule. If Y tends to K satisfy, Y tends to K is the association rule. If both of them are satisfying, then both of them are the rules in that case. The similar process has to be followed for all the frequent patterns so that we will get the final association rules in this case. So in this video, we have understood how can we find the frequent pattern rules and we can write the association rules using frequent pattern growth algorithm. So I have solved a few more examples related to a priori algorithm. Link for those videos is given in the description below. If you like this video, do like and share this video with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.